President. When you are the father of a 9-year-old and a 6-year-old during the holiday season, you spend an awful lot of time reading holiday stories. You spend an awful lot of time watching Christmas specials and Christmas movies on TV, and it's wonderful. I love it, getting to, you know, relive my childhood through the eyes of my kids. If you remember all of these stories and specials, there's a familiar theme that runs through them, and it's a really nice theme for kids to hear. The basic idea in many of these stories is that Christmas, Hanukkah, the holidays that we celebrate today aren't about pageantry, and they aren't about pomp and circumstance or the presents or material things, that it's really about celebrating each other. It's about sort of understanding what's important to us and who's important to us, and using this little break that we get at the end of the year to spend time with each other. And my youngest favorite of all of these stories and specials is the iconic Dr. Seuss poem about the Grinch, and it ends like this. He says, he hadn't stopped Christmas from coming. It came. Somehow or other, it came just the same. And the Grinch, with his Grinch feet ice cold in the snow, stood puzzling and puzzling. How could it be so? It came without ribbons. It came without tags. It came without packages, boxes, or bags. He puzzled 3 hours till his puzzler was sore. Then the Grinch thought of something he hadn't before. Maybe Christmas, he thought, doesn't come from a store. Maybe Christmas, perhaps, means a little bit more. It's maybe the most famous of all of the passages from Christmas stories explaining that premise, that this time of the year is a time in which we think about each other. And I hope that we do that in the Senate and in the House over the coming days before we wrap up for the year. Because as we approach the Christmas season, and as creatures of good fortune, those of us who get to serve in the United States Senate, as we begin to prepare to go home and share time with our family and our loved ones, we need to think about the crisis that many families are in today and will be in over the holiday season if we don't choose to do some basic things here attached to our responsibility as United States senators. We need to think about the position that we are going to put people in because of our inability to act and to pass legislation that prior to this holiday season seemed relatively non-controversial. Christmas is about celebrating our love for one another, and if we really do believe in brotherhood, if we really do believe that our role as United States senators is to try to lift people up around us, then we need to understand that the debates around health center funding or the Children's Health Insurance Program or the status of children who were brought here by their parents at a very young age from another country isn't about politics. It's not about scoring political points. It's about people and what we will do to people as we head into the holiday season. Adriana Bigard is a single mom from Hamden, Connecticut. And for her, the CHIP program has been a lifesaver. She's doing everything that we would ask a young woman to do. She received her master's degree in public relations from Quinnipiac University. She is now working as a public relations specialist, but she has a young son, a 6-year-old, Carter, and she's a single mom. And she gets a paycheck every week, but it goes out as quickly as it comes in. She is one of the millions of Americans who is working, who is playing by the rules, but is living paycheck to paycheck. And she gets insurance through her employer, but when she was told how much it would cost to add her son to her coverage, she simply could not afford it. She literally did not have the money in her monthly paycheck to be able to pay for gas and for groceries, for rent, and for coverage for her son. And so the CHIP program was a lifesaver for her. Her son now is enrolled in what we call Husky B in Connecticut. That's the name we use for our CHIP program. And without it, she says, things would dramatically change. If Husky goes away, if CHIP goes away, once all benefits, taxes, et cetera, are paid, I will not have enough money left in my paycheck to pay my rent. And that's what is consuming her this holiday season, because she just got a notice from the state of Connecticut telling her that on January 31st, her son Carter will lose health care insurance, meaning on January 31st, Adriana will not have enough money to pay her rent, or she will have to leave her son uninsured. That will be her choice come January 31st. That's a pretty terrible, awful way for her to spend her holiday season.